So, someone pointed out something I've been screwing up, which is cool, because there's so many little pieces. I've been making pre-morale checks for units in general order, and apparently no units in general order ever make morale checks. What I had thought, mistakenly, was that this was actually covered under, over here, this special structures individually called it out, but no, every general order position. I'm not sure I buy that, but I'm also not sure that I don't, which is to say that a unit position in a marsh or in a woods or in a small town or something, would they not make a morale check? Well, I can see arguments going either way, so we'll try to remember that and get it right from now on, but it's going to be tough because I've started to get into certain patterns. Okay, so if you remember, I was kind of lost, and I still am, looking for the leader for these. He is apparently not set up with them. I haven't figured out where he's set up yet. Didn't go to that. But first, of course, I had to look for him otherwise, and I found him on the chart, hewn. He's with the Artillery of the Guard Corps. Okay, great. There's a couple of cav detachments, that are with that. Not quite sure where he is, though, at this point. And so I'm looking at counters that kind of look like this, but maybe have an RA on him. It looks like it has one down here. And I've basically got to scour the map because I don't know where the fuck it's going to be. I've looked through this stack, through that stack. Maybe I'll keep looking through those stacks in the hope that they'll show up someday. He might be somewhere else. The other option is, of course, to start paging through the order of battle and try to find where he shows up there. And that'll give me a clue maybe where he was set up. It may not mean where he still is. But yeah, it's one of the problems with this design is it's just hard to find the leaders. And if they become separated, and this guy started out separated, it may be impossible to find. Because maybe he's on the floor, you know? I mean, I don't need him for anything until now. And the reason I need him is I need to make a roll for the Song of Napoleon or whatever the hell it is. And I'm having a really hard time figuring out if there's anywhere I can put in command, because I've got all these damn inactive markers, and it's really hard to see, well, okay, what formation is active now? But in the same way, I mean, if I did it in the other direction, I wouldn't be able... God, the planes make the whole apartment downstairs just vibrate upward. The guy fucking put in tile floors without following the rules here, I think. And this whole thing is... I gotta get the fuck out of here. Anyway, that's why I'm up right now, is they turned something on, fans or something, and it just started vibrating my whole apartment. It's like 3 in the morning or something. I get a couple hours of sleep every night and can't get anything done. But I have no fucking clue where this dude is. And I really am not even sure how I'm going to find him. It's very... Because of the way the game's... the graphical design for the game is set up, it's very hard to keep your units together under their commands or anything like that. So you just kind of fake it, along with, the rules, because they're kind of poorly written and put together, although maybe it's not as bad in the regs. Here's the hint. General Hewn and all elements of his force are active as well at noon. See grouping at Rosnitz. All right, so I look over at Rosnitz, and it looks like whatever was there moved. I don't know where the fuck it went to. But now I have to hunt for that unit and see what it was. And unfortunately, there's nothing that calls out Rosnitz. So I have to look at... Okay, honor within 2 hexes of something Rocknitz. That's... That's not it. You know, and I just have to work my way through all of these. Here we go. So it's the Guard Light Cavalry Division, which should have been active at 3 p.m. within 6 hexes of Rosnitz, which is here. Okay. That may be these guys. But I don't see his counter there. I'll look through the backs of them. Maybe the front is misrepresented. But, and I'm not sure this is actually it. Okay, wait. Hewn Reserve Artillery. There he is. Okay. So this shouldn't have left where it was, I guess. Let's see. Yeah. So I'll hunt those down and send them back. And, of course, these, it's not clear. There doesn't seem to be an activation on Gallitzin and Hewn. And I don't know, you know. Fuck, man. This is such a nightmare. What are these near Cates? What the fuck were these? I don't know. What I think happened was I didn't set these guys up in the right place. I gave them 6 hexes of Cates instead of Rosnitz for some reason. Or maybe there's something that looks like maybe Rocknitz and saw that instead of Rosnitz. Whatever. But I think these guys... Oh, wait, no, hold on. See, these guys say he and all his forces are active at noon. His forces say 9, except maybe these. And I don't know why he wouldn't be in the city. Is there something else called Rosnitz here? Yeah, I think I just wasn't very aware when I placed those units. But that's caused a tremendous amount of confusion. Guess I'll hunt out his pieces. And when I set them up, try to figure out, you know, they'll be active this time. But I have to make a roll against him to see if he is actually one of the people who has a problem. And I don't think he has a morale rating, so he's screwed. He can't possibly be active. Of course, and this is constant for me. I have to look here. So morale rating's down there. He's only got an artillery rating. So I guess he's frozen unless some leader comes and talks to him. Yeah, we're back to nightmare time in this game, huh? Yeah, I think I found the screw up here. I think what happened was whatever I did here somehow got combined with this, which is also active at 3 p.m. And because these are within 3 hexes of Cates, which is down here, and that's probably this command here, and I think this stuff is supposed to be down at Rosnitz, but somehow I kind of did a transcription error there. That's the best I can guess. When I look at Schwarzenberg's command, he's here. I think the only thing he has that's active, this is Gulai. He's fine. He's one of the chit holders. Is this Weisenwolf, who's the second line division. Okay, well, I start looking around and it's hard to see what that could be. But what I do find is when I look over here, I see second line division is 3 artillery pieces, the 41st, 1st, and 7th regiments. Okay. So here's a piece of the 7th. Here's a piece of the 7th. Oh, maybe not. Here's the 41st. Oh, yeah, because these are battalions. So they have different numerical positioning, like when you look at the designation. So this says 241. This will say 272. So the 7 is not where the 41 would be on this one. And that makes some sense because you're designating, hey, You know, it's a lesser unit of this or whatever, but it means that it's very hard to see what's what. So it's, again, another one of those design decisions I really throw into question in terms of finding it. As far as I'm concerned, I can't move any of this shit forward because I've allowed my divisions to kind of be positioned in a way that isn't proper. So it's going to make it harder. You know, I thought maybe I could lean forward with some of these units here. Like, this is the 20-something of the first division, I guess. Well, this isn't the first division. What are we looking at? Second division. So these look like units of the second. But, I mean, I can't go in with piecemeal with part of the units. I don't think. Maybe I can. And since I have so many command chits, let's just give him one. That's just going to apply to him. I mean, it can apply to all of Schwarzenberg, but I don't think there's anything else of Schwarzenberg's that's in command that it can operate. This shit, I don't know what it means that, you know, reinforcements are out of command that are already moving. These guys I'm not going to start because their commander's not activated, not out of command, but not activated. I've got the out of command markers, but they're French, so that should clue me in that this isn't right. And I guess this line just halts to see, hey, are we actually going to go forward? Napoleon's here, man. We're not supposed to fight Napoleon directly in battles. Isn't that what, like, Moreau and Jomini are telling us? One of them. I think it's Moreau who was the one who kind of formulated that dictum. Fight Napoleon's marshals, don't fight Napoleon in any battles. Always fall back from him. He's the dude who the monument's to. And now I'll look over at the Russians because... and the Prussians, for that matter. There may be some commanders in the Prussians that succeeded in making their chit. I wish I had chits that handled both sides of it, or at least enough chits to cover, you know, everything, because then I could rotate, you know, flip them or something to indicate who's in command and who's not at this point. But no, I don't have it for all my divisionals. A French chit first, and you know, mainly kind of pulling away a little bit, hoping to get a little bit of a breather here off the Napoleon's arrival. Some fire happened. Pajol's destroyed. I get all the way back to here on the offensive fire and then start trying to recover units. And I see this guy. I make a roll. I forgot that he was in a zone. And I haven't been allowing people to try to recover in zones, but he failed his morale check, and that would be a bad thing for him. He'd, you know, be doing involuntary movement out of somewhere. So I start questioning, hey, am I wrong about that failing morale check? Yeah, I mean, I haven't been playing very heavily recently. My life's fucking mess right now because... Anyway. So I look to the morale rules, which is where I expect to see recovery, and it's not here. And I remembered it wasn't here. And I don't know where the fuck it is. It's like buried in some rule on combat or something where it first discusses disorder and this. And, you know, I mean, I'm not going to finish this fucker, and I'm seriously considering just backing away and saying, I'd kind of like to see more of the assault on the city in the first day. I'm not even going to finish the first day. That's pretty fucking obvious at the pace I'm going. But I might be able to see a little bit more of what's going on. But man, these fucking rolls are just killing me. I mean, I can't even get through this pulse without, you know, something I'm questioning. I think for the most part I have the core of them operating properly, but they're just so fucking badly organized. It's under the formations themselves, which is weird. I mean, it makes sense in a sense, but there should at least be something tagging back to this over in the morale rules. These rules just need a complete rewrite. Anyway, as far as I can tell, they have to make the check, or they do make the check, even if they're in an enemy in zone of influence. So he's going to break, and I guess, take an extra hit that way. Allies are going later in the turn, which isn't surprising. Less chips in the cup. They only had, I think, 3 commands that they could activate. And their turns become a lot easier because other than hunting down and finding the couple of units that could still operate, and really, there was a little bit of action down here where you can see a breakthrough happening over here. And the Prussians, part of Kleist's unit moved, Kleist the Corps, one of his brigades had movement. I don't know if I've got them jumbled up too much, where I'm moving units from different commands that shouldn't be. If so, that's okay because you're kind of allowed to reorganize on the fly, but of course then I could have, I think, but then I would have done it here, so I'm not being completely consistent. But anyway, we had a little bit of advance coming into here, but now when I start to look at these, I see 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 4, 3, all of these moved. Everything seems kind of jumbled and not really very organized, and I cheated one way or another, either by not allowing the Austrians to move or by allowing the Prussians to move more of their units. You really kind of have to pay attention to this. So here's what's screwed up. So here, if I look at what he's got, those ones and twos, those are individual units, so I gotta find the other symbol, which I can't really even read. And I don't know if anything makes sense there. So this is 8 Silesian 3. What the fuck does that mean? Or something like that. That's gonna be the 8th Silesian Landwehr, if I can find that, which is over here. The 3 doesn't, that's this. So I think the only way that I know which brigade it's under is to actually match up on this chart, and there's just no way I'm going to do that because I don't see anything that gets me to 11 here on that organizational number. So this is like, it should be like 11-8-3 or something like that, and it's not, and it's actually in the opposite order of what I would expect in games. So for designations, as far as I'm concerned, we just fake it as best as we can with those Prussians, because I really, and sorry about my jittering, I'm constantly being vibrated, and I had coffee today, which, like, the vibration, this is not what I'm feeling in the room. This is the after effects on my body of a combination of coffee and continuous very low, like, automobile idling. It's been kind of quiet today. Anyway, we'll fake it as much as we can and see where we can get with it. But the cool part was, hey, I didn't have to move a lot of units because of this special Napoleon thing, but it does make it a little bit more work to hunt down which units get to actually operate. And then, I don't know, what the hell. I think after this turn, I'm done. I really do. It doesn't make sense anymore. Right, I think we finished up the last of the chits for this turn. And I have some serious thinking to do. I still have a fair amount of video. I could get another turn in on it before I quit. But at least I'm getting to see the beginning, and this may be why I'll do another turn, of the Dresden specific rules that kind of paralyze the Allied army. So the chit was the leader chit, which is kind of the big one at this point. So all the leaders with a command point generation are now running around, like Gilai is down here, Schwarzenberg over here, and trying to wake people up. I've got Detali running down here. I guess he's got to get to there to activate these things. That's where the commander for those is, I think. And he's got these troops to go look out. And basically, those things just can't go any closer. Over here, the job's a little simpler because things are tighter packed. But throughout this side of the battlefield, there's a lot of disorganization. At the same time, Napoleon, using the same chit, has moved his way up, and he's somewhere on the board. There he is. He's got a green uniform. He's thrown some aide-de-camps up as well, like here. Very Austrian-looking uniforms. I mean, how am I supposed to tell? You know? Yeah, sure, there's a Napoleon on this one and an eagle on this one. But that's not the kind of quick clue that I want. And again, you know, the game's put a preference towards a beauty and a minis-type feel of let's get the paint job on the uniforms correct, and the players are in charge of, you know, trying to remember what belongs where. And there may be some little clues like the Napoleon or that, but my eyes don't see that from this distance. Did have a little problem of my own making. I rolled dice on the table, and a couple of times I've knocked pieces around. I found some Russian or German skirmishers, I'm not sure which, I think they're Russians, over here where they totally did not belong. Kind of in the French lines, so I picked them up and moved them there. Over here in skirmish formation. I don't know if that's where they were, but it's close, and it'll do. And now I gotta think.